Have you ever tried German chocolate cake frosting sweetened condensed milk before? If you haven't, then I suggest you try this recipe. It is a beloved treat, unlike any other. What separates it from regular cakes is that it is occasionally decorated with maraschino cherries and sometimes frosted with chocolate buttercream. German chocolate cake does not contain a strong cocoa flavor. So indulge in a layered chocolate cake topped and filled with coconut pecan frosting. Also, sweet baking chocolate is traditionally used to enhance the cake's flavor. What is German chocolate cake? German chocolate cake is a moist and light chocolate cake with a rich and delicious coconut pecan filling. However, it resembles a red velvet cake without the food coloring since it does not have a strong chocolate taste. Likewise, it is not as sweet as a bar of ordinary milk chocolate and not as bitter as a dark chocolate bar. For this reason, it is a combination of the two with 48% cocoa content. Though it is called German, it originated in America. In 1852, Samuel German, an American baker, created dark baking chocolate for the Baker's Chocolate Organization. In honor of him, Baker's German Sweet Chocolate is the brand name of the product. Today, many bakers have adopted this dessert all around the world, even baking companies. What you will need on how to make a German chocolate cake frosting sweetened condensed milk. Ingredients for chocolate cake. 2 cups of all-purpose flour. 2 cups of granulated sugar. 3/4 cup of unsweetened cocoa powder. 2 teaspoon baking soda. 1 teaspoon baking powder. 1 teaspoon salt. 2 teaspoon espresso powder. 1/2 cup of vegetable oil. 2 large eggs. 3/4 cup sour cream. 1/2 cup of buttermilk, room temperature. 2 teaspoon vanilla extract. 1/2 cup of hot water. Ingredients for coconut pecan sweetened condensed milk frosting. 1 can of sweetened condensed milk. 1 cup toasted chopped pecans. 3 egg yolks. 1/2 cup of butter. 1 1/2 of teaspoon vanilla extract. 1 cup shredded sweetened coconut. Step by step to make German chocolate cake. Step 1. Preheat oven to 350 degrees Fahrenheit. Then grease or spray 8x3 baking pan, line with parchment paper. In a large bowl, whisk together the flour, unsweetened cocoa powder, espresso powder, baking soda, and salt. Set aside. Step 2. Using a stand mixer with a whisk attachment, pour in the wet ingredients egg, buttermilk, oil, and vanilla until incorporated. Step 3. Pour the wet ingredients into the dry ingredients and mix to combine them. Add the hot water to the batter, and then beat until it is thoroughly incorporated. Step 4. Pour the batter into the greased baking pans, then bake for 45 minutes, or until a clean center comes out when a toothpick is inserted. Invert the pan on a wire rack to cool, set aside, and make the frosting. Step by step to make coconut pecan frosting sweetened with condensed milk. Step 1. Place the butter, egg yolks, and condensed milk in a medium-sized saucepan set over medium heat. Simmer for 10 minutes while constantly stirring until bubbles start to form. Step 2. Remove the saucepan from heat and stir in the shredded sweetened coconut, toasted chopped pecans, and vanilla extract. Set aside to chill for at least 15 minutes. Step 3. Cut the cake and frost it using an angled spatula of your choice. Once done, you can chill or serve. Tips and tricks. Place the oven rack on the center, have at least 1 inch of space between the pans and the oven's sides. Ensure that all the refrigerated ingredients are at room temperature, so that you can easily mix the ingredients. If buttermilk is unavailable, you can make your own, by just adding 1 teaspoon of lemon juice to 1/2 cup of whole milk, stir around, and allow to settle for several minutes. Espresso powder will not make your chocolate cake bitter, instead, it will activate the chocolate's rich flavors. Toast pecans for 5 minutes at 350 degrees Fahrenheit, so that it's warm when stirred into the frosting. Cool entirely before icing since it prevents the frosting from turning into a sticky mess. It is also best to use sweetened shredded coconut because it improves the frosting taste and gives excellent sweetness. Likewise, never substitute butter with shortening because butter is tastier and richer than shortening. In thickening the frosting, it is ideal for cooking it longer till it is reduced further. Besides, it will thicken as it cools. If you liked this video, don't forget to like and subscribe.